I'm setting up my little cutting room. This trailer's basically a Swiss Army trailer. It's got everything in it for survival and cutting opal. I've never had the pleasure to work on a piece like this before. I've worked on a lot of opal all my life since I was 8 years old. I've been cutting, but this is a new challenge for me, absolutely.
This could possibly be museum quality. This piece is so old, ancient, and fragile. One little slip, and we could cut it down to a quarter of its value.
That there is just the most beautiful fossil stick lying on top.
The 5-kilogram specimen has two valuable elements. Rare pipe opal formed when silica fills a tubular space in the host rock and solidifies, and an ancient opalized fossil stick sitting on top.
So if I broke that, for instance, and the pipe does go directly underneath it, it could be a specimen that started off with the potential of tens of thousands to just a few thousand dollars. We don't want to have to saw it up, Sophia will kill me. So there's a bit of pressure on here. I'm tackling this pipe first. I've got to expose the pipe opal. It's a valuable part. I'm removing all the mother stone, trying to get down to the crystal colour. You can see the pipe runs through there. There's a big piece of ironstone that I need to get rid of to expose the colour, but I still want to leave this stick intact. If I touch that, if I wreck it, then it's going to destroy the fossil value. I won't touch that with the machine at all. It's a slow, tedious job. I'm going to be at this all night. There's still a bit to go, but what I've done is I've exposed the main bits of the piece. $1 million question, though. What's she worth? I mean, this is nearly priceless. I've never seen a piece like this, you know? And guess what else? There's like another 6 pieces. These are the ones that come out of that big clump that you found.
Oh, awesome.
And this one's really bright. The other one from there.
Very, very saleable colour, this one. What's going on the back? Anything on that?
Yeah, it's got this laser show going on. It's really random, hey?
Oh, okay, so it's actually double-sided.
And the other smaller one, is that one?
Let me just make a few notes.
No worries.
The Opal Whisperers have found yawanut, pipe and fossil opal, featuring blues, greens, purples and golds with a rare double-sided piece. And they've been partially rubbed.
Okay, so the parcel, the specimen.
Yeah.
What's our total?
Okay. Provided my math is correct, we have $37,300.
Woo! I'm happy with that.
I'm happy with that. We did good.
Sophia has estimated the 6 finished yawanuts will be worth $7,300. And the museum-grade pipe opal fossil, $30,000. For the young guns, a disappointing season so far all rests on the results of 12 hours washing their stones in a homemade tumbler.
Oh, look at this.
Bloody hell.
Holy moly.
There it comes.
Yeah, that'll do for some good.
No! Dude, look at those colours. Look at that.
Enormous.
That is beautiful, boys.
It's like a mountain of opal.
Holy moly. Mountain of a day.
Dude, so, that stone alone is probably 2 or 3 grand.
What the hell?
There's reds, greens, blues. Damn.
Holy.
There's definitely thousands of dollars here, like right here.
Look at that.
Look at that. That is like ridiculous.
Jesus Christ.
I don't know how much something like this would even go for. This is just ridiculous.
You reckon we'll make your dad jealous?
For sure. Opal doesn't get nicer than that.
Here we go.
Dad, what's going on?
Hey, Jay.
Hey, fellas.
We got something pretty cool to show you this morning.
Jamin's dad, Graham Doughton, is one of Whitecliffe's foremost opal valuers.
Yeah, we thought we'd better bring this one to the professional to...
Oh, wow, that's actually really good stuff now. Oh, that is actually gem, that one.
That's the best stuff there, for sure.
Yeah, absolutely, look, that is beautiful. That is really beautiful Whitecliffe's crystal, that. Gem.
The young gun's find is crystal opal. At a centimetre thick, it is highly desirable for high-end jewellery. It has clear blues and greens. It's in the rough, and once cut, they will have 30 grams.
When I look around, just looking at the quantities that you've got, I think, just as a bit of a rough ballpark, you know, you're probably looking at least 20,000.
Well done.
That's hectic.
That is so good.
Well done.
That's so good. That is unbelievable.
You guys are starting to make a bit of a go of it now. Doing well.
Absolutely.
You must be feeling relieved.
20,000. Yeah.
Well done. Power to you guys.
That's massive.
So what do you reckon? You reckon we're real open miners now?
You've still got a bit to go. No. There's still a few things, you know, to learn.
Yeah.
So what do you reckon, boys? You're sticking around for the rest of the season?
Bloody oath.
The big one's coming, boys.
This is just one of them.
You know, little fish today. The $1 million might be next week.
Oh, yeah!
With this haul valued at $20,000, their total is now over $37,000.
How's that barber going, bro?
Yeah, it's coming along nicely, mate.
How about a beer?
Yeah, I'll have a beer. Awesome.
Thank you. Mate, on beer?
Yeah, Arthur.
Yeah, sweet.
Unfortunately, in the last few weeks, we've just had issues just ramping up on us. So it's getting to the point where all the machines really need a good go over. It's getting way too hot out here. We've got crumbling walls, we've got flies all over the place. And it's a good time to call it, I think.
The Mooka boys have been forced to stop mining, finishing their first season as independent miners using Leif's claim and equipment.
I hope Leif will offer us back for another season. The relationship's going good with him. I'll be here next season if he'll have me, that's for sure.
It's been a good season working with you, Leif, mate. Appreciate everything, eh?
Yeah, no, same, mate. It's been good.
Yeah, absolutely lovely being out here open mining, and even with all the troubles, man.
So does that mean you're going to have us back next season?
Yeah, we've got to finish what we started.
Yeah, excellent, man.
I'm in, man. I'm in for sure. Maybe next time we'll find our big win, eh?
I reckon I got something that'll keep you interested, eh?
Yeah?
Have a look at this.
Holy hell, man.
There were parts found by a friend of Dad's, not too far from here on the next field.
That's got some nice red in it, man. That's a nice little bundy there. This is a quartz rock.
Yep.
Whoa. We got access to this field?
Well, it was a friend of Dad's that was working down there, and he's getting a bit older and going to retire.
Really?
But he showed us a few spots around there where he got this sort of stuff.
Okay.
You like them?
Yeah, beautiful, mate.
Have a look at this. He's the big brother.
Holy hell, are you kidding me?
God!
That is one serious slab of eyeball.
That's the reason I want to go looking in this spot.
That's all quartz as well?
Yeah.
It's holy
natural dark opalized quartz.
Opalized quartz, such as this one, can be worth tens of thousands of dollars for a pristine specimen.
That is the biggest chunk of quartz opal I've ever seen.
Look at the colour in it, mate.
It's an example of what Antamigra has to offer around here. The barbecue at the end of the day was a perfect opportunity to reveal these stones to the boys, and, you know, just show them that they're still these sorts of pieces out here. And yeah, that's one of the things Antamooka's famous for, these big, large, unique pieces.
What does this weigh?
7.8 kilos. 37,000 carats.
One piece.
Right. Future's looking good, you know? I was just starting to think that maybe there isn't any opal left, but he pulls out pieces like that, there's definitely opal left, mate. Definitely.
So I'm helping the bloke to sell it.
Wow.
Yeah, he's going to show us the area that he got this.
Good work, Leif. Yes,
I think we got some good things coming.
I'm keyed as well.